In this video, I'm imagining that I've got some kind of a nonlinear element, and I've got an equation model that came from a curve or surface fit. Basically, the equation model takes two flows as inputs, manipulates them to generate two efforts as outputs. So this would be a generic version of something like a turbine, which takes in flow rate of the fluid and angular velocity of the turbine shaft, and it calculates a pressure drop and a reaction torque. Okay, so I've got E1 and E2 here. I've put two 1 junctions in, and what I want is I want a two-port element that will allow me to implement those equations. Now I could take the transformer, which is a two-port element, and I could connect port 1 like that, so the power variable from the one junction F1 goes to port 1 of the transformer, and then I connect the other bond like that. Now the transformer default causality is the causality at one port is not equal to the causality at the other port. It's got to be flow in, flow out, or effort in, effort out. Now I'm going to double click on this transformer. Here are the default equations. Okay, it's set up to take in one effort and one flow as an input. What I want to do here is I want to first of all define the parameters of my curve fit equations. I don't need to give them a value in the declaration. I only need to declare them. I could say real A1. Actually, I could say real A1, A2, A12, B1, B2, B12. And then, actually, you know, I'm going to give those separate declarations, because I'm going to show global variables later. And I need to put semicolons at the end of these statements. Copy and paste those. B1, B2, B12. Okay, there are my parameters. And when I run the simulation again and I click on the Show Parameters dialog box, it'll ask me to put values in for these. Okay, my equations, well, I want to modify those. Suppose I wanted to define some variable names that were a little more intuitive than just port number dot effort or port number dot flow. I could say real effort 1, effort 2, flow 1, flow 2. Maybe those are pressure, torque, whatever. Now the equations, if I just put the equations in, let's see. First of all, what are my two inputs? My two flows are the inputs. Whoops, gone the wrong way there. My two flows are the inputs. So first let me say that flow 1 is port 1's flow, and flow 2 is port 2's flow. Okay, so I've given the 20 sim power bond variables the, you know, what are supposed to be more intuitive names here. So those are the inputs. The outputs are effort 1 equals, was it A1 times flow 1 plus A2 times flow 2 plus A12 times flow 1 times flow 2. Semicolon at the end. The effort 2 equation was very similar, except that it's effort 2 and it's got B parameters. Okay, you know, if I wanted these to be squared, I just make them squared. But for now, that's what I got. On the power bonds, power 1's effort, bond 1's effort, that's what this 20 sim equation model has to give at the end of the day. That power variable is effort 1. Port 2's effort is effort 2. Okay, so these are equations which are consistent with the causality that I have in mind for this element. However, when I click on the single gear to check the submodel, it gives me, B1. Okay, there's an error. Check again. Okay, causality related errors. And it's because I haven't done anything about 20 sims default causality constraint on the transformer. I'm going to double click on this again. I'm going to go into the interface editor and I'm going to double click on TF. I need to click on the TF. Okay, so power port 1, yeah, it's a bond graph input. Power port 2, it's a bond graph output. click on the name of the element and it'll give you port relations. If I click on that, now I see the causality restriction. Transformers aren't supposed to have two efforts or two flows coming in. This is not a regular transformer, so I'm going to remove that causality restriction. Okay. Second thing I think I'll do is I'll click on the icon tab here. I'll double click there. I'll double click on that text box. I'm going to call this an RTF. And the reason I'm going to call it that, this is completely optional, it's not a normal transformer. It's got a bunch of losses in it that I'm not capturing in first principles. Okay, so there's dissipative, all kinds of different effects in here, maybe. I'm calling this an RTF to convey that it is not a power conserving transformer in the traditional sense. So file, exit, update the graph first, yes. Okay, so now I've got the RTF. Now, if I check the submodel, it's still telling me that I've got those errors. Let me see here now. Edit that. TF, port relations. Okay, the causality restriction is gone. I think what I'm going to do here is I'm going to go into model. I'm going to reset causality. And now I'm going to analyze causality. Okay, so now it sees that the equations of the RTF are set up to have flow in, flow in. If I check the complete model, I get no errors. And now if I go down to here, I get no errors. Okay, so sometimes you have to reset the causality so that the causal strokes end up where you want them. So now we're good to go. By the way, there is a handy feature in 20Sim. If you've got multiple parameters, sorry, if you've got multiple bond graph elements which use the same parameter, so if you had a fluid friction and a fluid inertia and a capacitance and they all needed the same diameter, if you want to change the diameter of the pipe, well then you've got to go in and change the each individual element in which that parameter appears. You can use global variables. I'm going to go into the signal library block diagram. And I'll go down to sources. I'm going to pull in a constant block here. And I'm going to rename it variables. Well, technically they're parameters. They don't change during the simulation. Okay, and in here, normally it's just a place where you can define some parameters. Let me get rid of that. I'm going to say real global A1 equals 1. Real global A2 equals 2. Real global A12 equals 3. So what I'm doing here is I'm declaring these parameter values all in one place, and because they're declared as global here, these are now accessible anywhere else in the entire bond graph. So I've got these global declarations for parameters. I can go in here now and I can say real global A1, real global A2. I don't redeclare them with specific values, obviously, but I do have to declare them in the equation submodel. So now when I run the simulation, okay, if I change the values of those parameters in this block, they are automatically updated in any submodel that uses them. Okay, so that could be a very handy feature as your model gets bigger. All right, apart from that, that is how you modify a two-port element. We removed the causality restriction by going into the interface editor and clicking on the element itself. Okay. We could have gone into the individual power ports and we could have changed the direction of the half arrow. I could have had fixed effort out as the causality, because given that equation model, it's impossible to invert this. I need to have effort out and flow in. So it would probably make sense for me to constrain the causality of the individual power bonds, and that way it would make sure that the causal strokes were where I wanted them. I wouldn't have needed to have gone back and reset the causality and then had the software assign the causal strokes again.